This is Gospel Music Today. Now, here are the hosts of Gospel Music Today, Ken and Gene Grady.
We're very glad you could be with us this week on Gospel Music Today. We have Southern Gospel news coming up, some concert updates, and Gene has a feature group.
All the way from Nashville, Tennessee, it's Mercy Road.
I'll be talking to Devin McGlamory of Ernie Haas and Signature Sound on today's program, and you've been listening to a new CD.
Yes, some new friends that I met at the NQC. They're called His Mercies.
We will have Christmas music on today's program by Ernie Haas and Signature Sound Tribute Quartet and some friends of ours from Bucharest, Romania. The New Levites have a Christmas song on today's show.
Next on Gospel Music Today, Ken talks to Devin McGlamory, and we'll have a music video by the New Levites. Welcome back to Gospel Music Today.
We have a Christmas music video coming up, and it's a little unusual because it's from two friends of ours who have become long-distance friends. They watch the program on the internet in Bucharest, Romania, and they've been in contact with us a couple of times, and this time they sent us a music video version of God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen, and they have a very nice message attached to it.
That's excellent.
This is Daniel and Emmanuel. They go by the New Levites. They live in Bucharest, Romania. This is God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. That's up next on Gospel Music Today.
God rest you merry gentlemen, let resting Mary's gentlemen. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Savior to save our son from Satan's power when you were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy.
Gentlemen. We are at the National Quartet Convention, sitting with me, Devin McGlamory of Ernie Haas and Signature Sound. And Devin, welcome to Gospel Music Today.
Thank you very much. I'm excited about being here.
We're glad to have you. Now, we've mentioned Ernie Haas and Signature Sound. Everybody knows that connection.
Yes,
but you have an amazingly successful solo CD that's out now. We're going to talk about that in just a minute. But let's go back a little ways first. You began with the Dixie Melody Boys.
That's correct.
Age 17?
That is correct. Somebody's done their homework. 17, I spent 5 years at the EOU, Ed O'Neill University, there, and met my wife while I was there. And then after that, my tenure there, I moved on with Karen Peck in New River, and I was there also 5 years. And I've been with Ernie now. This is my fourth year with Ernie, so it's been a great ride.
I guess so. Did you sing before that? Were you? Did you? Was this a dream of yours?
I did. I traveled as a kid. I actually, I remember coming here when I was 12 years old, and Mom passing out my solo tapes and that kind of stuff. So it's always been a dream of mine to travel, and I had no idea I would travel as extensively as I have the past few years with Ernie. We've literally, last year, we went around the world twice in 1 year, and it's been absolutely amazing. It really has. I'm blessed and humbled.
That's great. Now, the Love is a Verb CD. One of the reasons why I brought you back to your childhood is the influences that people know about are very traditional Southern gospel,
sure,
with Ed O'Neill. A little different with Karen Peck and New River.
Sure.
But the new CD has really a wide variety. Where did all that come from?
It's very eclectic background as far as there's different genres on there. And I tell people in my solo concerts, if you don't like something on there, you just don't like music. Because there's some pop feeling stuff, of course Southern, because that's in my blood. There's some country feeling stuff, and very traditional things as well. Some black gospel sounding. I grew up in a family that just loved music. My dad would be riding around the truck one day, and one day it would be the Inspirations and the Dixie Melody Boys or something like that. And the next day it would be Celine Dion and Whitney Houston or something, and then Garth Brooks and the Eagles. And so it's just, I grew to love music that was good. It didn't matter to me what genre it was.
Right. Well, it's what's the current single off that CD?
The current single right now is From My Rags to His Riches, written by Joel Lindsay, Wayne Hahn, and Ernie Haas. Very excited about that because it's not only me on there. My friends, the bluegrass sensation right now, Daly and Vincent, are on there with me. We just found out that song was also nominated for a Dove Award for Country Song of the Year and Overall Song of the Year. And I started crying. I'm not going to lie.
That's great. Is there a Devin McGlamory website?
There is. It's very simple. DevinMcGlamory.com. And the store's on there, the link for the booking and things. It's this time of year, the bookings are kind of unique because we're back in full swing with Signature Sound. We take the summer off, and a lot of people have booked Doug Anderson and I together, and that's really fun. We normally take a piano player and have a blast. But there's a way to book on there and all kinds of stuff, pictures, and it's pretty cool. So I've got a new music video out. It's just hit YouTube. It's for the song on my record called While I Still Can. It's about my kids. So if you want to see my kids, they're in my music video.
Okay. Yes, we do want to see the kids. Well, Devin, thank you very much for being with us on Gospel Music Today.
Thank you very much. It's been an honor. Thank you, guys.
Well, that's it. We're completely out of time for this Christmas edition of Gospel Music Today.
And Ken and I both wish you and your family a very Merry Christmas.
Very nice.
We'll see you next week on Gospel Music Today.